Democratic Senator Elizabeth Warren in Massachusetts has not formally declared she's running for president. She's done everything but. She set up an exploratory committee and has taken to the road, which may soon become the campaign trail. Tonight, she's in Puerto Rico and making her first appearance on CNN since getting started. I spoke to her just a short time ago. Senator Warren, you're in Puerto Rico tonight. Can you explain why you're there, especially so early on in your campaign?
So I've been talking about a government in Washington that works great for the wealthy and the well-connected, but not so much for everyone else. And I've been doing that for a long time. Puerto Rico is one of the prime examples of that. Right here in Puerto Rico, an island that's been devastated both by a financial crisis and by twin hurricanes, right now has a government that is taking money off the island in order to send it to Wall Street and cutting services, healthcare services, schools, right here in Puerto Rico. It's just a prime example of government that works for the rich and the powerful and doesn't work for the people.
Do you believe that the government in D.C. is complicit in the in keeping the body count of the actual death toll so low for so long? We've now learned through various studies that thousands of people died in the wake in the months after the storm. Do you think the government is complicit in that?
The death count in Puerto Rico has been proven to be now in the thousands. And the fact that this administration has refused to acknowledge that and continued to put out reports long after the evidence was available, showing just a very small death count, is just one more way in which the people of Puerto Rico have been disrespected from start to finish since the hurricanes hit.
Just in terms of the shutdown, the Senate's going to vote Thursday on two partisan bills that have no chance of passing both chambers. Is that really the best that lawmakers can do? Does either side have a right to be proud of what's happening right now?
Look, we need to open the government. People are working jobs. I today was with TSA agents who are out doing their jobs trying to keep us safe, and they're not getting paid. People have been shut out from the jobs that they need to do. The government needs to be reopened. There are two ways that can happen immediately. Either Donald Trump could say he's ready to sign something to open the government, or Mitch McConnell could just put the same budget bill on the floor of the Senate that was voted overwhelmingly in December. This is a manufactured crisis, and it's starting to impose real pain on families all across this country. Federal agents are not political pawns in some game that the Republicans want to play. We need to get the government open.
The president's party, though, controls the White House and the Senate. Democrats only control the House. Do you ever think, look, the realistic end game is that Republicans get
yes.
two-thirds of what they want and Democrats have to settle for the shorter straw? Isn't that how the balance of power works?
Well, let's talk about the balance of power. There are two co-equal branches of government, the President of the United States and the Congress. The Congress of the United States, in December, the Senate voted on a funding bill that was a compromise between Democrats and Republicans. The House held it up. So when the House came back into session after the year, the new year in 2019, they passed the funding bill. We have the votes on the congressional side. But so far, Mitch McConnell is saying no. The only one who has any power in Washington is Donald Trump. Mm. And he's saying he won't bring any bill to the floor of the Senate that can't be passed, that the president won't sign into law. That's basically just abdicating the responsibility of Congress. We had a compromise proposal. Democrats and Republicans, everybody had signed off, ready to go. And then Donald Trump blew it up for his own reasons and said he would be proud to shut down the government. Well, that's what he's done. And we are now sitting here in the longest shutdown in American history, and it's hurting people
yeah.
all across this country. It needs to stop. Reopen the government.
I want to ask you a little bit about the presidential race. I know you said you're delighted that Senator Kamala Harris has announced her candidacy for president. Are you concerned at all about how she and other centrists, you might call them, may run or attempt to paint you as too far to the left? Is too far to the left a mantle you would happily embrace?
Look, I'm out talking about the economic issues, about how government works, about what's happening to middle-class families, working families all across this country, why the path has gotten rockier and rockier, and why it has gotten so much rockier for people of color. This is what I've worked on all of my life. And I got into the Senate race in 2012 to talk about these issues, to fight for these families. Now, here I am as we look at 2020, just right in the center of this fight. This is what I'm going to continue to talk about. And I'm delighted that there are lots of Democrats who want to talk about ideas, who want to talk about a way to build a stronger America. I believe in that. You know, I'm somebody whose daddy ended up as a janitor. I got my chance in a college that cost $50 a semester. And I got a chance to be a public school teacher, a chance to be a college professor, and a chance to be a United States senator, because America invested in that opportunity. I believe in investing in opportunities for our kids. I think that's how we build a real future in this country. And I'm out there and willing to fight for it.
So to voters who look at the economy, see it booming, credit among other things, the president's tax cut for that, I'm wondering what you have to say. Have the tax cuts had a positive effect on the economy?
Oh, look, giving away $1.5 trillion to corporations, to billionaires, to the wealthy and the well-connected, while young people are struggling with student loan debt, while families can't have prescriptions filled, while infrastructure crumbles around us, that's not how we build a future in this country. You know, the way I see this is it is this fundamental question. Who do we think government ought to work for? This economy? Sure, there's some great numbers. The rich got fabulous tax breaks. Wall Street has been up and down, but back up. But the lived experience of tens of millions of people across this country is the squeeze. It's about flat wages and increased costs for housing, for health insurance, to get your kids educated. You know, we have a country that's getting richer and richer, but the problem is that too much of that wealth is flowing just to a thin slice at the top, and everyone else is getting left behind. Mm. That's not how we build a future.
The president has obviously had his fair share of racially charged things to say about you, if not outright racist. Yesterday, on Martin Luther King Day, Congressman Hakeem Jeffries called the president the Grand Wizard of 1600 Pennsylvania Avenue. Is that an appropriate thing for a sitting member of Congress to say about the president?
Look, the president has made clear where he stands. And he did that in Charlottesville. He's done it over and over. What matters is that we, as Democrats, make clear what we stand for and what we're going to fight for. Look, for me, I believe in the wealth, I believe in the worth of every single human being. I think that recognizing that worth, and then as a country, saying we're just going to invest in some opportunities, a level playing field, a chance for a kid who's the daughter of a janitor to be able to go to school, to be able to get an education, to be able to build some real security in her life. I believe that that is the best of America. I believe in an America that reflects our values. But we're going to have to build it together. We're going to have to take our government back. We're going to have to take it away from the wealthy and the well-connected who've turned it in their direction. And we're going to have to make it work again for the people. That's the reason I'm in this.